Dear participants, I take the privilege in welcoming you all to the third day live webinar on that is alumni webinar series organized by Satyabhama IEI student branch in association with the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering and the Institution of Engineers India. On the third day, we have Mr. Selva Vasant, a technical lead from Tata Consultancy Services, Chennai, who has joined today to handle the session on future trends in information technology. A special greetings to you, sir. We welcome you, sir.
Thank you.
I take the privilege in introducing Mr. Selva Vasant. Mr. Selva Vasant has started his career as an associate consultant, and he has been an open text content management since October 2014 to 2017. Then he had been a senior software engineer since 2017 and later as a team lead at Tata Consultancy Services. Now, at present, he is the technical lead at Tata Consultancy Services, Chennai. He is certified with ITTL Foundation Certification in IT Service Management and IBM Certified Application Developer in the Cloud Platform V1. He has a sound knowledge in the handling the issues on OpenText Live Link Content Server. He is also expertise in WebLingo. He is also expertise in WebLingo Smart UI Line Appearance Customization in Live Link. He has good experience knowledge in the OScript development and experienced in debugging and the development issues and fixes, and also in the web reports and live reports. We are very happy to have you here, sir. Now we can start the session, sir. I'm handing over the session to you.
Thank you, ma'am. Yeah. Hi, guys. So today we are going to see about future trends in information technology. Why I came up with this topic, the reason is, so as I'm an IT guy, so I can give you some glimpse of in the future technologies so you can understand what is the future trends in IT rather than just you are just learning Java or .NET instead. So if you are going to the future trend, so obviously you will be having a sound economy in the future. So that's the main motto I choose this topic. So, okay. So these are all the topics I'm just going to talk about today. So let's start with an intro. So which we will see this topic in the forthcoming slides. Okay, so the term, so information technology, so why the name IT? So here we can see, so it was first coined by Information Technology Association of America. So they say that this is the part of study, design, development, implementation, support, and management. Okay, so means, so just say there is a company who need a software to easy their work. For an example, so recently we have did the project for a firm called Vistian. You may be heard of. So Vistian solution, that's my client actually. So what we did is there is a invoice management system. Okay, they have the hard copy of invoices that need to be digitalized and stored in a content manner. I mean the document manner in a digital document. Okay. So for designing this system, so what we need to do? So how, first of all, need to see how they are storing the documents. So that is study, okay? Now we studied the process, what they are doing, and we need to do some design, okay? In the design phase, so we need to write the algorithm to make sure how the design, like algorithm flow, okay? Not the code, so code will come under development. So designing the algorithm, I mean writing flow, writing down the flow, how the program should work, okay? That will minimize the customization error and everything, okay? So once we have the algorithm, we are going to the development phase. So once we on the development phase, we are having a process of how it should be developed. So just consider there are multiple teams to be involved for the development. So either maybe a Java or .NET or so and so, whatever it is, okay? So even Python or Perl. So multiple programmers need to be sitting together for this design phase. And in the development phase, they will start their work individually. So they will they are having their set of codes, okay? So they will develop their code, and implementation part will be the integration and the production move, what we say. So in the development, it will be there in the development phase. In the implementation phase, it will be there in the production phase. So it is a combination of integration of multiple codes to a single code. Okay, it's in a single repository or single module, I can say. Okay, so single module. So once we have the module in place, we need to make sure how it works. Okay, so that's will come under testing. So that will also be on the implementation phase. And once we have the code in the production, so we need to support the code. So someone guys will say, and hey, this code is not suitable for me, so I need some little customization, or I need to edit this code, so that will help me a lot. Like, we will having a lot of customization, so that will be come under support. Okay, so this model will be derived under two ways. Okay, so one is a waterfall model and agile. So I don't want to go much in functional. So one is a waterfall model. This is the steps how we are going to develop till the implementation and the support. And the agile model is how it's another model. So currently you may be heard of agile. So agile model is now in place. So it will improve the process and it will improve the productivity of the team. So I don't want to go much in technicals. Okay, sorry, functional. Okay, so this is about the information technology. I'm going for the next slide. Okay, so this is again says, okay, I have a lot of slides, so I'm just explaining what it is. So in information technology, so if you can see this tree, it's not a single language or single module, which we can say there are a lot of modules in place and a lot of applications can be involved to produce. Okay, like a mobile app, jQuery, HTML, SMM and banners, etc. Okay. Okay, so in the future technology, so we can say what are the things which will rule this IT in the future. Okay, Internet of Things, which is already started, this era is already started. Virtual reality, which is already started. If you are having the latest mobile, so you can use the virtual reality, and you can see everything. Like for an example, in the Niagara Falls, so you can just put your mobile in your eyes with the special glasses. So probably you can see the image like a close stretch on the Niagara. Okay, so that's about the virtual reality, big data analysis. Okay, I will be explaining this topic in the next slides. Big data analysis, cloud computing, 5G wireless technologies. So in this session, I am going to talk about this five technologies, and later in the future, okay, this is going to rule the future. So next three is going to rule the future. So it's already started. So this first five technologies already there in place in the market, and the next three technologies going to rule the future, and especially artificial intelligence. So you may be using Google Lens or recognition, character recognition, image recognition, video recognition. So everything will become under artificial intelligence. So if I want to recommend, if you want to learn something to improve your career, obviously I will be asking you to go ahead with the AI or the blockchain technologies. So this too will be helpful in the future for you. And this five and this one, enterprise software. So it is already there in place now. So this is also having a good scope for next 15 years. And these two things, artificial intelligence and blockchain, will be there in the market for the next 20 to 25 years. So there'll be the blooming technologies, and other two things you can see seamless by voice recognition. So voice recognition through phone. So currently we are having the call centers, which we say, okay, I press this number, press this number. The future, so there will be a robot, so which will be built with artificial intelligence, which can recognize your voice and it will navigate or it will help you accordingly. So that is voice recognition. And wearable technologies, we are having a lot of wearable technologies like Google Glasses, okay, smart watch and smart band, etc. Okay. So this is the wave or era, I can say, about the information technology, where it starts and where it is now. It just starts with the stream engine, okay, telegraph, newspaper, etc., etc. It says each and every category. So the companies, sectors, each sector, like a clothing sector, and where it is now, okay, in the fourth wave. So you can see cloud, quantum computing, etc., etc. will be here. So as we are saying about the industrial intelligent automation, so in information technology, the current era, it starts by 1980s, okay? So everything starts by 1980s, the automation level. So this IoT, so many of you heard of embedded systems where the IoT presents. So embedded systems, it starts around 1960s and it was coined with the name called IoT, Internet of Things. So everything will be connected to the internet and it will improve the analytical ability of the system and the performance, and it reduces the manpower and improves the productivity, etc. Okay. So this is where it starts, starting with the robots everywhere, like car manufacturing, like your Intel chipset, etc. So everything is under robotic control. Okay. So even the future of farming. So especially this picture in the center, so if you can see, there are red dots, green dots, yellow and orange. So it says the temperature in the land through the remote sensing, through the satellite. Okay. So it just sends the data and inform to the people or the farmers, say this location is having some issue, or maybe a temperature level, or maybe a water field or whatever it is. Okay. So based on that, so they will be having some way of improvement in the land. So, and it will improve the productivity of the land. So we can get more crops. So, and this robot, okay. So this is a tractor with automated robot. So you may be seeing this in the Interstellar, the movie. So everything will be automated in the future. It reduces the manpower, it improves the productivity, etc. Okay, so this is just an intelligent automation transportation system. So there will be a central hub. Okay, so it will connect each and every vehicle which pass on. Okay, just consider there are 100 vehicles in a location and there are just 2 vehicles in a location. The priority should be given to the signal that 100 vehicles, hence it is the maximum number to be passed on. Or just say there is an ambulance coming in the surroundings. So this sensor will sense the ambulance and it will open the particular signal rather than any other signals. Okay, just again, the cargo ships for automation navigations, construction lorries, trains and cargo planes. Maybe you are heard of the autopiloting. So a lot of sensors you involve, you may be heard of in the flight. So now they are going with the auto takeoff and auto landing process as well. So they are automating everything. So the autopiloting is already there in place. So now they are trying to automate each and everything. So yeah. So first topic, which I am going ahead with, the Internet of Things, IoT. So the era starts at 18s, okay. But the fact is what, it was not coined as the Internet of Things, but it was coined in the year 1999. Okay. And from then we are using that word Internet of Things. Okay. Who coined this word? The guy name is Kevin Ashton. So at the MIT Labs, Massachusetts Institute of Technology, he coined the term called the Internet of Things for the process of RFID, radio frequency identifier, where he implemented on a chipset for the student identification, or the document identification, etc. So this is what he has coined at the time. Okay, so in the term IoT, Internet of Things, so the connectivity to the internet devices increases day by day. Okay, if you can just see this graph on the year 2003, so in the world population was 6.3 billion and connected devices was 500 million. So if you are jumping directly to 2020, if you can see, there are 7.6 billion and the connected devices 50 billion. So the average connected devices per person is 6.58. Okay, so just consider your home. Okay, you are having a smart TV, you are having a smart watch, smart band, mobiles, each and everyone having a mobile, etc. So you are now, it's the era of connected cars, so Kia Motors, MG Hector, etc. So this increases this connectivity devices per person, and this is about the IoT region. So this is the improvement in the IoT phase. Okay. And okay, in the term IoT, what it should be? Okay, there are three layers which we can say: sensors and actuators as input and output, and the connectivity to the through the internet, peoples and their process. So sensors and actuators, okay, just consider there is a AC in your home. Okay, that AC should have a input as a sensor which senses the temperature of the room, and output as an actuator. Okay, so we are setting the level 17. Okay, once we set the level 17, the AC will switch on and it will try to cooling the room up to the temperature of 17. So once it reaches that temperature 17, it will cut off the outdoor unit. It's a freezing unit. Okay, so once it cut off that unit, so through the, okay, once it cut off the unit through the actuators. So that's how the process works. And connectivity. So just consider you are switch on the AC and you went somewhere else to the remote location. And you forgot, hey, I switch on this AC and forgot to switch off. Okay, now we have the remote system. So each and every mobile having a remote system, and your AC will connect through the Google pod or any Amazon pod. Okay, and it will be connected through the IoT. So wherever you are, so you can switch on or switch off your AC. So 2 days before, so Apple has introduced the system. They have launched their new connectivity system. So in the forthcoming mobiles, okay, in the future, they will be having a smart key technology for the cars. Okay, you are having a smart key. Just consider a BMW. Okay, they are having a smart key, and you are having an Apple future phone. So you can scan the data from the smart key to your phone. Okay, so now on your phone will act as a smart key, and you can use your phone as a smart key while you are entering your car or you are going to drive a car, etc. So this is all the futures of technology through the IoTs. So people and their process. So analytics, customer relationships and support, location tracking of your device. So you may be heard of the electrical vehicle as a geofencing. Okay, just say my vehicle should just go to 50 kilometers and it should not cross that boundary. Okay, so everything will be processed through IoT through the internet. Okay, so in the year 2014, the revenue was around 180 plus billion for IoT. If you can see the managed services, it's of 86. Enablement hardware 16, and network services it's of $77,000. So if you are seeing of 2020, even the year didn't end still. So it's of 571 for managed services, and the hardware it is 43 from 16, and network services is 387 from 55. So see the growth. Okay. So that's why I'm saying, so if you're going with the IoT, if you land IoT, so probably you will be having some good scope in the future for 10 to 15 years. Okay, so currently we are having 4 billion connected people. So people out of 7 billion, so we are having 4 billion of connectivity between the peoples. And revenue of opportunity, 4 trillions, and apps, how many apps are available, and embedded technology systems available, and GBs of data. So here, why are the big data coming? Okay, I will explain the next slide. Okay, and I'm going to the next topic called virtual reality. So everyone know about a virtual reality should be. So virtual reality is the illusion of three-dimensional interactions. Like, it's very simple. So if you are the engineering background, so you should be knowing about the gyroscopes, MEMS, microelectromechanical systems. The sensors will be used for this virtual reality phase. Just you are just bending your head down. So the picture will be moving down through this gyroscope sensors. Okay. So there will be a virtual world around you. It will be an emulation or simulation which will produce the world through your eyes. Okay. So this is about the virtual reality and the history of virtual reality. It starts of 1915. So you can see the device in the right hand side. It's very huge. Okay. So and now you are seeing that with the current technology in this 50-60 years. So it's just your mobile, or just you have to wear the Google lens or whatever, Google Glass or whatever it is. Okay. So type of virtual reality, immersive VR, okay, using your response, which will come through. Windows on world, it's for your desktop. So using your hand, so this technology can be seen in maybe the films, lot of films, Avatar. So that is a base of creating the VR. Okay. And the telepresence, so like one human will be there in projection, okay, human projection. So like he will be there at some other place and his projection will be here. So that is telepresence. So presence through tele, like a IT or information or internet, okay. So the data will be passed from a particular camera in a different location to a screen here, okay. That is telepresence, and then augmented reality coming. So augmented reality is the future trends. So like you have seen the film Iron Man and Jarvis, okay. So everything is virtual reality, okay. So you can imagine everything. So you can present everything over there. You can build it using simple your hands. You can emulate or whatever it is you can do. And the application of VR, entertainment and movie, just wear a glass and you can see the movies wherever you are. And biological, okay. So now we have a system. So just even a capsule will be swollen by a patient. It will just go on through the process of your nerves or vein or whatever it is. So if there is an operation to be made, so doctor from the external can able to control a capsule robot to do the operation or much process. So if there is an issue with the system, so everything can be identified or operated or whatever it is. So games, VR games, which is already there. So you may be heard of the forthcoming PlayStation. So that the VR involves and the big data. So first we saw about IoT, and then second is virtual reality, and third is big data. So what is big data? Big data, okay, biggest data. Okay. So IoT, we are having seven connected devices per person. Okay, 7 devices are per person. So we are having 4 billion people connected through the internet. Okay, so just imagine about the data processing and the data storage. Okay, you are having a Google Cloud. Okay, where you have stored all your documents for the future reference or whatever. So each and every user will be given with a 15 GB of free space in Google Cloud. Okay, just imagine how many people is there having this account of Google, and just think about the trillion size of data. Okay, trillion data will be stored, and eventually you are just going to access only your data. So okay, just consider some 100 people having this data will be there in the cloud of Google Drive. Okay, so this 100 persons data, just consider 100 GB. So this data will be stored in the same server, same storage medium. It is fragmented. Okay, you will be having your data and they will be having their data in a single storage. Okay, but if you are trying to access that data, your data should be correctly fetched and downloaded to you. Okay, for this reason we are having the big data, which will be enabling or synthesize the data processing and improve the performance speed. Like okay, 100 documents, I have to fetch only my document, not any other document. So if it is 100 documents, so just consider in your room you are having 100 documents, it will take time for you to manually process. Just consider about the system. So you need to process 1 trillion data. Okay, if it is a 1 trillion, okay, just consider 1 trillion document, it have to find the exact document which you want to download. Okay, if you want to download that particular document, so there are a lot of process involved in the backend, and there should be some AI concepts also involved to fetch the data. So this is about the big data, very huge data. Okay, an evolution of technologies. Okay, so here we are having the telephone to mobile, desktop to cloud platform, the car to smart car. Okay, why I'm saying this, I will let you know. So see the cargo, gas pump. So how much petrol or diesel I just put for this day. So etc. So a lot of steps involved. Social media. So just see here. So you may be seeing this somewhere. So 17,36,000 plus Instagram picture has been uploaded per minute, I guess. So it's of number of likes and number of photos on Facebook, number of emails processing by the exchange server. Okay, 300 hours of video upload in a minute, I guess. And the number of tweets per minute. Okay, just consider everything in a minute. Okay, so this, see the bulk of data. Okay, and this is about the retails, about the big data. And what is big data? It's a large complex that is being difficult to process using on-hand database system, normal database system, RDBMS or MongoDB, etc. cannot able to process this kind of data. Then we need a special medium. Okay, this is about the growth of data. In 2012, we had 20 zettabyte of data. Okay, in 31%. Okay, it just says about the data improve. So currently, if you can see 150 or 200 zettabyte of data this year, in this last 8 years. Okay. So 5 V's, which is required for this big data. So volume, how much volume or how much data will be there? So what varieties of data? The categorization, it's a JSON file or it's a music, or it is a camera, or it is a PNG file, etc. And what velocity the files will be processed, and what value the file is. Okay, just consider there is the junk files, so that will be having less value. Just consider there is some invoices that will be having more value. Okay, and veracity. Okay, uncertainty and inconsistent in the data. Okay, inconsistent data's in place. Okay, consistent and inconsistent. So there are a lot of phases involved in this big data analysis. Okay, what it should be: cost reduction, and then fast and better decision making to improve the search, improve services and productivity, next generation products. So these are all the multiple tools which is available, so that we can utilize for this big data. And Hadoop is the most famous tool around the system. So cloud computing. So in the sense of cloud computing, so we are having the system which is stored everything in the one storage location in a faraway location. Okay. So this is the diagram which symbolizes the cloud computing. So you are having devices at the external, but you are having everything in the internal: database, network, storage, runtime environment, etc. So here is the SaaS. Okay, these are all categorized into three: SaaS, software as a service; PaaS, platform as a service; and infrastructure as a service. I just left with 6 minutes, so I'm just going to rest up this session. So software as a service. So what is software as a service? Okay, you are having Google Mail. Okay, so you are having Google Mail. That mail, you are directly involved through the browser. Okay, you are doing everything through the browser. That is nothing else as software as a service. So software will be everything there in the cloud. So you are just going to the URL to access the software to see your mail. So that is SaaS and PaaS. So platform as a service. So here they will be giving some platform, and you have to develop your code, like application programming API, okay, application programming interface. You have to develop your code and you will get it processed. So maybe you heard of the Microsoft Azure. So that is a PaaS based application. So platform will be given, storage will be given, and you have to develop your code accordingly. So infrastructure as a service. So in this infrastructure as a service, they will give you a computer in the remote location, and they will give the network to access and the storage to store the data and the load balancing. Okay. So this is about the cloud architecture. So service. So base is the infra, and above the platform will be there, and the service. So this is about the three layers: base, middle layer, and the upper layer. Okay, these are all the different commercial clouds available. So you should be heard of AWS, Amazon Web Services. They will be giving the cloud called Amazon Elastic Computer Cloud. Okay. And a lot of companies will run this: SunJava, VMware. So 5G wireless technologies, again the mobile technology with the different generation. So now it is in the fifth generation. Okay. And okay, so this is about the generations. I don't have much time. So 5G is mainly for the speed of network. Okay. Here you can see the number of cells involved and transport data. So OTT through the mobile. And about the capacity, quality of experience, and the green technologies involved, and the cost effectiveness.
Mr. Shalva,
what's that? Yeah, no, I'm just left with 4 minutes.
Yeah, we are getting short. Okay, running short of time.
Yeah. Okay, fine.
Okay.
So that's about, I have completed everything. So this is about the conclusion of what all the trends and technologies available. So probably you can just find everything through the internet, or you can join some courses and learn everything. So that will be the future trends and technologies in IT department. So that's it. Yes, ma'am, you can go ahead, please.
Yes, sir. Participants, if you have any questions, you can ask him or you can post it in the chat box. Thank you, Mr. Selvavasan. You have given a very beautiful insights of the future trends in the information technology. Thank you so much for spending time with us. On behalf of the management of Satyabhama Institute of Science and Technology and Satyabhama IEI student branch, we express our profound and most sincere gratitude to you, sir, for your excellent coverage to future trends in information technology. The session has been quite educative and it was very interesting and informative. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Dear participants, we have one question from Sai Teja, if you can answer him quickly. Among IoT and machine learning AI data, which I have to learn?
I can say it's AI. So
AI.
IoT is already started. Okay. So AI is blooming now. So AI having a lot of scope in the future. So IoT, I can say, will sustain for 10 to 15 years. But okay. If you consider AI, so it will be there till 20 to 25 years in IT.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Sai Teja, for your question. Okay, dear participants, the attendance and the feedback form is in the chat box. You can fill the feedback form. Thank you for the 3-day alumni webinar series. We have come to the end of the series. Happy to you all. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Thanks, ma'am. Thank you. Thanks, everyone.
Yeah.